Currency black market exists primarily in nations that are economically weak, with high inflation rates, low currency reserves, etc., or have limited supplies of foreign currency, in this case the US dollar. As a result of that, the currency black market is flourishing in nations like Iran, Argentina, and Venezuela, as the government doesn't have enough supplies of the US dollar and the black market satisfies the shortage.
There have been nationwide protests going on in Venezuela for a long time now. The current president Maduro is considered a dictator by the population of Venezuela. But as a result of the protests, the only thing that happened were over 100 arrested protesters and a dead policeman. That means that there are no signs that Maduro's left-wing regime is close to being over. While these events are taking place, the Bolivar, Venezuela's currency, is depreciating at a rapid rate. It frequently fell more than 10% per month. In the last 6 months, however, the black market currency appreciated, despite the fact that prices for black market goods were skyrocketing. This steep rise ended in October, when the Bolivar had also lost a third of its value compared to the US dollar. So, in short, the black market currencies in Venezuela is weakening the Venezuelan Bolivar.
Que yo tengo tiempo y paso por un supermercado, yo me meto a ver qué producto consigo, porque a veces uno consigue algún producto exquisito, como por ejemplo un cornflake, o a veces no consigo nada. La multitud que llega al supermercado es tal, no solamente para entrar, sino también para pagar. Entonces la experiencia de comprar se vuelve una cosa de 3 horas horrible para comprar 3 pistoladas.
Quería comprar pan de sándwiches, tampoco había. No había café, no había prácticamente nada, sobre todo había frutas y algunos vegetales. De tal manera que ahora me explico por qué no había cola, no había gente. Compré cambures, compré lechosa y compré un pimentón. Esto me costó 1.600 bolívares. No voy a decir que es barato, pero eso fue lo que había, no había mucho más que comprar.
Acabo de buscar mi bolsa solidaria en un club. Me dieron una leche, 1 kilo de caraotas, un aceite, 2 kilos de harina pan, 2 kilos de arroz y un jugo de guayaba. Esto después de anotarnos en una lista hace 3 semanas, donde nos censaron, censaron los hábitos de mi familia, censaron cuántas habitaciones había en mi casa, cuántos baños, cuántas personas vivían en ella. Y a las 3 semanas entonces nos llega nuestra bolsa solidaria. Obviamente esto tiene que durar un mes.
Aquí en esta bolsa, mire, me enfoque la bolsa, acá no es embuste, mire. Esto es, miren, recorte de pescado que está comiendo la gente, miren, cabeza de pescado, miren. Esto es lo que está comiendo el pueblo. Esto es lo que está comiendo el pueblo, porque la carne y eso, el pollo, se lo comen solo socialistas, miren. Esto está comiendo el pueblo, miren. Recorte que antes comían eran los perros, con el perdón de los perros. Las declaraciones que dio la gobernadora Elisa Santaella, que los CLAP, los mal llamados CLAP, ella dice que los escuálidos, que la oposición no tiene el derecho a ellos. Miren los huecos que he tenido que hacerle 10 huecos para poder, miren. Mira como yo era de gordo, miren cuántos huecos le he echado a la correa, la dieta de Maduro. Los CLAP que estamos viviendo, lo como nos suena el estómago, el hambre, clap, 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 clap. Eso es lo que estamos viviendo.
Stability in Venezuela has declined because of the political tension. Public spending on the US dollar in the black market grew drastically, and as the political and economical situations in Venezuela get worse week by week, people will wish to purchase even more currency in the black market. Additionally, this has built up from many years of failed socialist policies by the current and previous governments. Nicolás Maduro, on the other hand, blames this on his opposing parties and on the United States' economic war against him.
GDP is heavily damaged by the presence of the black market in the sense that the government cannot possibly account or record any of the transactions occurring in it. And therefore, because of this, they cannot possibly make any tax revenue. And therefore, this decreases their GDP. Due to the fact that Venezuela's GDP is highly dependent on oil exports to the US, amounted to 96% of the total GDP of the country, means that they don't have many ways or sources of income for the country. This means that the current fall in oil prices for the per barrel in Venezuela has fallen down to the low 40s from the high $100 per barrel, and this is creating a devastating situation for the country. Good afternoon. I am here now today, this evening, with Mr. Ponomarenko. He's a macroeconomist, and he has a theory he wants to share with us about how Venezuela can confront this new rise of black market and actually make a profit out of this situation.
Thank you, Mr. Crowther. My solution is to take the barriers from goods and services that are currently popular on the black market and to remove those barriers and make these goods and services legal, because as a result of this, the government of Venezuela will be able to collect taxes while the consumers will be able to have slower prices on the goods since they're legal now, and the black market doesn't have to go around the government's cost barriers. That way the government can also save money, as they receive more money from taxes and they reinvest that money into infrastructure, subsidies and education.
In terms of economics on a national scale, it could be said that imposing price barriers or price ceilings, prohibition of various goods and services, and any other economic limitations on the market can directly provoke an emergence of a large market, black market, that will later only weaken the economy over time. Another conclusion that can be made is that alleviating the barriers, such as the ones above, has a positive impact on an economy, as things that were impossible to be purchased and accounted for legally are now being added to the national output of the whole economy and are now contributing to government income, because any income made from previously illegal goods and services can now be taxed.